It was an extremely high privilege for me to be associated with Emory on that Sabbath in Africa project that Benjamin Baker mentioned, along with some others that are probably known to several of you, Keith Burton, Joan Francis, Bertram Melbourne, Harold Lee, Ganoon Diop. The goal of the project was to try to help the church to a broader and fuller understanding of the history and contemporary significance of Sabbath observance and how that understanding places people of African heritage at the very center and not the periphery of this thing that we call the story of redemption. As I reflect on Emory's legacy, the word that kept coming to my mind over and over again was a simple word, generosity. And the previous speakers have talked about this in many ways. It was a generosity that was gentle, unobtrusive, but powerful. It made an impact. And the way that that happened with the Sabbath Roots Project was that, of course, he shared his vast resources. Now, in the book, Elder Bradford pays tribute to him, thanks him for the use of those resources. But then in conversation and in our presentations that we made in various places, Elder Bradford really expanded on that. And the fact is that in really making a solid historical case, he could not have done it without some of these books that were extremely valuable, but old and kind of obscure and out of print. But he could have not have made the historical case that he did without the generosity of Emory Tolbert. Generous, but made a powerful impact. And I personally benefited from that in many ways. I can't take time to elaborate very much, but if I could speak just very briefly on behalf of the broader community of Seventh-day Adventist historians, I know of instances, a couple of instances, in which he came to the aid of fellow historians, colleagues in the Adventist community in times of very difficult times of crisis. Another example of his generosity. And then just one more briefly, Ben Baker mentioned the fact that he, Dr. Tolbert, was generous with veteran ministers who wanted to write their autobiographies, their memoirs, if you will. Now, in that book on Elder Humphrey, My Soul Doth Magnify the Lord, here's how that generosity, gentle yet impactful, taking things to a higher level, because he also included in that, Dr. Taylor mentioned the primary sources. He put in there sources that helps understand the times, and I was so excited by some of those sources that they sent me on a trajectory that has just been a huge impact on my own personal research and writing. And I'm just one person. Just think of all those who have read that, all of the students, many of you are here, and multiply that out. So what a loss, Sister Tolbert and family. But also, wow, what a wonderful legacy. Praise God, as Emory rests in the Lord, his works do follow him in a powerful way as he awaits the call of the life giver.